How's it going, everybody? Anonymous Disco here, and today gonna be playing some more Armored Core for Answer. Counting down the days till Fires of Rubicon. We're close. August 25th, I believe. But anyways, the plan for the next few streams of for Answer here is what I'm gonna be trying to do. I'm gonna be trying to unlock the Orca ending. I actually get a walkthrough pulled up in front of me here, so it doesn't kind of kick off until chapter 2. In chapter 2, I'm gonna have to do a mission called Rescue GA Transport, and then that should. And it's kind of like you unlock other missions and kind of. Anyways, I'll keep you posted as it goes. But anyways, we're still in chapter 1, so we can just bang out chapter 1 here. And then chapter 2 is when I have to kind of carefully start choosing my choices. And, this has always happened in Armored Core 4 Answer. It freezes during the cutscenes. But no matter. Anyways, we'll bang out chapter 1. I kind of have to dust off the cobwebs anyways, because it has been a minute since, played a little Armored Core. Sorry, I'm also smoking a cigarette. Put that out. Alright. Anyways. We're going to play this mission. I'm going to dust off the cobwebs. We'll get ourselves to chapter 2. Then once in chapter 2, I got to rescue GA Transport. And then that should unlock another mission. And if I follow all these correctly and I make all the right choices, I should unlock the Orca ending. And the reason.
Destroy the Arms Fort Gigabase. It's being escorted by the 8th Fleet. Use the VOB to close in on Gigabase. Watch out for long range fire. This Arms Fort is a defensive stronghold. Don't underestimate its firepower.
Oh, fuck. Okay. No, the reason I want to do the Orca ending. One is just to, you know, get the get as much shit from this game as I can. But also, you get the 12 Orca ranked matches, I believe, which I haven't done yet. So that's kind of the big draw for me. Forgive my playing, because I haven't played this in a while, so I gotta kind of just remember the controls. It's hard to see. Oh fuck! It took so much health. I got battered there. Probably gonna have to do this one again.
VOB depleted. Purging.
Alright, here we go. Oh, I'm in a tank.
Combat damage at 70%.
Alright, it's 70% combat damage. Yeah, that's it. So that's it, huh?
Commence mission.
All right.
Destroy the Arms Fort Gigabase.
Let's try that again.
It's being escorted by the 8th Fleet. Use the VOB to close in on Gigabase. Watch out for long-range fire. This Arms Fort is a defensive stronghold. Don't underestimate its firepower.
It's kind of like Radon, you know, in the Radon boss fight when he first gets to him and he is firing all his big arrows at you. And they just fucking smack you around. It's kind of like that. Ah, oh, fuck you. Fuck you! Fancier with it. Fuck you, asshole.
VOB nearly depleted. Prepare for normal battle maneuvers. Approaching the edge of the combat zone. AP down 40%. VOB depleted. Purging.
Get me out of this thing. Get me off this crazy thing. Just need to get close so I can stop firing this big missile weapon.
Good, you're in close. Save Giga Base as quickly as possible. Stop wasting time.
A little sloppy, Joe. I apologize. But we beat it. We beat it. And that's what matters. It's more I'm just trying to remember the controls. Okay, now I'm just going to keep consulting this walkthrough. Just make sure I'm not fucking anything up. But it doesn't say I really have to do anything. This, you must complete the mission, rescue GA port, and two more missions in Chapter 2 to unlock the mission, defend Megalus. Okay, so we're still good. Let's try to support the Red Barret Assault. Let's try to skip the cutscenes. They just seem to freeze anyways. But yeah, getting pretty excited for Fires of Rubicon, man. I've really been staying away because I know there's a few YouTubers I follow that have got early access to the game, but I'm really trying to like stay away. Well, I've got like a close range like melee weapon attached. I got, because this is more my ranked match.
The transport
build.
Unit has reached the combat zone. Escort the transports as they pass through the area.
Interior transport reporting. So you're our escort today? Good luck to both of us.
This is like more my ranked match build. So it's not maybe the best for missions. I might want to rethink this.
transport unit selecting shortest route.
Excuse me just a moment. Talk business. But like I was saying, this is kind of my ranked match build of my core here. So that's why I got like the tank legs just for as much health as possible. I got the slug gun equipped, which, you know, does the trick. I've also got this like melee punch thing equipped too. So like, sometimes when you do these missions, you want something that's a little bit more, got a little bit more ammunition and some more ass on it, you know? Anyways, I don't even know where this fucking truck thing I'm supposed to be keeping up with this. This thing I'm like, okay, there they are. Get up ahead of them here and take all these guys out. We should be okay. We should be okay.
We've detected enemy contacts along our projected route. Please eliminate them.
What do you think I'm doing? Well, how should we punch this guy? Punch this guy, too. Oh, you don't say. You don't say. It's a need to want work. Yeah, so I'm really hoping I can unlock this Orca ending, because then you get the, from my understanding, you get the Orca ranked matches afterwards. So I mean, that's pretty slick.
Contact enemy units ahead. They appear to be large old type units, more than enough to stop the transports cold.
Rank matches are like my favorite thing, or like, yeah, I really like the rank matches. I hope they're in Fires of Rubicon too. Oh, this one punch was good. They call me One Punch Man. They call me Saitama. Because I'm fucking one punch in those dirty sacks. Sometimes you get to punch your sack. I don't know. What do you want me to tell you? They punch you right in your sack. This should be the end of their route. I feel like a mission in like Spyro the Dragon or something. You know what? I'm not hating this build right now. I might leave it.
Mission complete. We made it somehow.
We made it somehow. Drive me insane. Oh yeah, escort missions drive me insane too. But that's not an S rank. I gotta tell you right now, I don't know what is. If that ain't an S rank, I don't know what is. Oh, ho, ho, ho. I know, when you call him, you call him. When you call him, you call him. Defeat wonderful body. Right, let me do that.
This is your mission.
I believe I fought Wonderful Body in, oh, I can get a... I can get a little guy to go with me. Who do we want? Give me Roy Solland. Give me Roy. I want Roy. Where's Roy? I need Roy on this. Just tell him. Tell him I know Roy. Tell him, you know, they know me. They know me down there. Tell him I know Roy. Say Roy. Say Roy to him. and they'll get you in. They'll get you in. Yeah, tell him I gotta talk to Roy.
Commence mission. Eliminate the target next, wonderful body.
Wonderful body.
This is my bliss, ready for action. Let's get this over with.
Finally, they've thrown a next at me. The Interior Union drank their feet too much. What the?
Dead.
I can't die. Not here.
Oh, I'm not gonna kill you. At least not yet.
Confirmed. Wonderful body has been destroyed.
Looks like it's
I'm gonna keep you around for a little bit of fun.
GA jobs are a piece of cake.
Didn't even need that guy with me. Holy.
I'm a fan of easy work.
Is that guy gotta take 15% of my pay cut? Whatever. Arm weapon. Cool. Okay. It's the attack on B7.
Okay, I'm here.
Let's go. Let's go get at it. I was looking at figurines for Armored Core because I was like, I'd love a little Armored Core figurine. And there was some people selling White Glint. And it was like, I think it was like $500, $400 or $500. I'm like, oh, man. I would love that. That'd be so cool. But, can't afford it. Way too expensive.
All units assume battle ready formation.
Because what got me thinking about it was Fires of Rubicon has turn around here. Has a collector's edition that comes with, I guess, somebody called Tenderfoot. Now, off the top of my head, I wasn't familiar. I don't know if that's a new character or not. But anyways, they have the core, a little figurine core of it. I can't remember quite how big. It was fairly big, though. I think it was like 6 inches, six to eight inches or something like that. And maybe even bigger. I don't remember. But anyways, I really wanted that, but again, I couldn't even like really afford it. But it was like you get the figurine, an armored, or you get the game, I think, and you get like a steel book, and I think like a little soundtrack or something. Steel case, maybe.
Normal units en route from HQ.
I'm all running scared.
Enemy reinforcements inbound. Coming in from above.
Okay, not really gonna flex on him, break up the slug gun. Miss a turn? Am I going the right way? Am I, what's really good. Must be somewhere down this room, right? Like, it must be, what am I missing? Is it up here? Do I gotta get up there? Maybe not. Fuck. Sorry.
do you want me to kill?
There's somebody. Oh, what about down here? Okay, not my finest work, but we got there.
Here is your mission. The client.
Should I even take somebody with me? Do I even need it? Let's try it with nobody. And then, if we need it, we can come back and select somebody.
Commence mission. Eradicate the enemy fleet and enemy arms fort. Special edition normal detected. It's equipped with a frontal shield. Don't waste ordnance on that shield. Maneuver behind it and strike the rear hull.
Hit it from behind.
Oh, I get that. I get that.
Gigabase identified. It may be a relic, but it's still an arms fort. Don't underestimate it.
I think I got everything in this Giga base, so I'm just gonna get the other guys.
targets destroyed. Mission complete.
All right, looking good. Okay, now we're gonna take back Cradle 21.
This is the mission. During...
I got quite the thunderstorm going on where I'm at right now. So I don't know if you're hearing a couple crackles of lightning, but it just puts me in the mood.
Commence mission. Gets me. Retake Cradle 2-1 and eliminate the Liliana insurgents. They're extremists, but they can only deploy normals. No match for a next. You should have little problem taking them out.
It's a leaks inbound. Crap! It must be the leaks doing.
Soldier! Nothing more than a wild cat without fangs.
It's a cool, setting. All the settings. I'm excited just to see, like, a new Armored Core game with just that really crisp, nice, next-gen graphics. Really exciting.
Fire! Blast them! They're soldiers like us! We can take them!
Five targets remaining.
Only five?
For the future of humanity.
I might switch out the tank legs though, because it's a little harder to get aerial in the tank legs. A little slower. Where's the last of these chumps? Oh no!
Nothing more to say.
Oh, thank you. Defeat Carbonara or the Spirit of Motherwell? Let's do the Spirit of Motherwell.
I'll tell you about your...
I'll tell you about your mission. I'll tell you about your mission. I'll tell you what you want, whatever they really want. But yeah, I think like I was saying earlier, there's a few YouTubers I follow that have gotten like early access to Fires of Rubicon, and I haven't even watched it. Staying away. For the most part, it seems like it's, you know, people are digging it. Some more than others, I think. But they just don't get it. Anyways. I just haven't watched anything because I'm like, I know I'm gonna like it, and I don't want to either. I don't even want to see it. My eyeballs keep a lot of fresh when I own that game, you know. Oh, fucking lightning! It's like flashing right by my fucking window too. It's trying to kill me, man. You like defeat it and then all like the fucking all the big drones like come out of nowhere and then starting to tear this thing apart, man. We are taking heavy damage.
much more punishment does this thing need? I'm gonna run out of ammo for all my shit. Yeah, if we lose this, we might have to rethink this particular build for this.
Down 70%.
For this mission, but that's fine. Whoa, but you heard that one. That was a loud one. A crackle of thunder. Where does the thunder end and the destroying of Mother Will begin?
That's an order.
I can't.
I'm gonna have to rethink the core for this mission because I'm just like out of ammo for everything too. Almost had it towards the end there. I'm just gonna switch a few things up in the core, I think. And then, I'm gonna try that again. So let's go into our system here. Oh, wrong one actually.
We're gonna. That also looks like a cannon, right? Like, getting close, or we... okay, so it's these black things. Those black triangle things at the edge. That's what we want.
Fallen.
Mission complete. Now you can really call yourself.
I don't think I beat that one in my original go through. That one's tough. Just because it's like. I'm just getting confused as to like which were cannons and then some are robots and then some are like. And it's definitely like a kind of a strategical one too, because you really got to conserve your ammo and stuff, you know? Anyways, a lot of fun. I think that should probably push me to chapter 2. And if that's the case, I'll probably just leave it there. Oh, cool. Robots don't look at explosions. But I'll probably just leave it there. Either way, I'm but then now, yeah, so this is chapter 2. So now that we can kind of, we've gone to chapter 2, we can kind of start to work on that Orca ending a little bit. Yeah, see there. Okay. Thank you. That's the one I gotta do for the next one. This rescue the GA transport unit. That one's gonna help me get the work ending. But we'll leave that for the next stream. Thank you for watching this installment of Armor Core. I hope you enjoyed. Like and subscribe if you did. And yeah, everybody, we'll talk at you soon. Peace out.